Shalom. This is Mary Omni from the World Government House of King David, Holy Covenant Constitutional Enforcer.
Spending most of their lives living in a pastime paradise. Been spending most of their lives living in a pastime paradise. Been wasting most of their time glorifying days long gone behind. Been wasting most of their days in remembrance of ignorance, so disgrace. Tell me who are they? Dispensation, isolation, exploitation, mutilation, mutation, miscreation, confirmation to the evils of the world. And spending most of their lives living in a future paradise. And spending most of their lives living in a future paradise. And then looking in their minds for the day that sorrows lost from time.
This is a Republic Notice. The title of this Republic Notice is called White Majority Living in Pastime Paradise. It's 2013, the month of December. We're past the cosmic alignment. And the white majority in America is still living in the pastime paradise. Now, they've been living in a pastime paradise for a very, very long time. Not only here, where we see it on a ground level, but in as their spirits in higher dimensions. The pastime paradise is of those who never look to the holy kingdom, those who never really cared about a holy kingdom or future paradise or an everlasting eternal immortality kingdom. They wanted immediate gratification. So those who wanted immediate gratification, like Esau, live in a pastime paradise. And a pastime paradise means it's time that will pass, and that will is and always have been just an illusion. The only real time is eternal, which is timeless, which is the true immortality of the millennium kingdom, of the everlasting kingdom of King David, the future paradise in which those who are constitutional, holy covenant heirs of Judah, Israel, and Ephraim, and Manasseh, and the Israelites will be living in the future paradise. The pastime paradise is those who did not care about an eternal kingdom. They cared about immediate gratification. Now, in America, we have this fuel engine of dung who wanted to live in a pastime paradise, and they're in the white majority. And they wanted to base their law strictly on skin and a herding of themselves like animals. So their law is just like white skin, majority herding. And then they get upset when somebody like Oprah say, well, you know, you're still doing this, you're still trampling, and you're still treating black people a certain way of the color of their skin. But they have gotten so into their pastime paradise and their immediate gratification that they don't even really think about others. They're in a pastime paradise. And that pastime paradise is like an abyss. They're in a mental abyss. They're in a mental abyss already, and a lot of their pineal glands are calcified. That's why in the medical books, they didn't even want to identify the pineal gland as an organ or as anything significant in the body. If you look in old medical books, you know, sometimes you won't even find it. And this is what you should understand about your so-called degrees and your degrees in medicine and engineering and all that stuff. It's based on a pastime paradise. It's not. It's based on an immediate temporal framework of an abyss rather than the true cosmic eternity of millennium kingdom and timelessness. Okay. Now, the Black Americans in the Constitution, the majority of them is living in a future paradise. You know, they was to do the penance, the suffering. They did 400 years in North America alone. They were in the other Egypt, because like North America is like the second Egypt that they did. They was in the other Egypt, and then they had several other captivities, because, and they was the ones who went through the captivities for the future paradise, because the everlasting and eternal kingdom is a future paradise, is the reality of true creation, okay? So rather than living in a false reality, you know, Black Americans chose to live in a true reality of creation, because creation is eternal. It was created by an eternal hand. And so it's everlasting. And therefore, that's a future paradise, an everlasting, eternal hand of governance. Now, what we can gather from the Black Americans is that they have this eternal energy because they are unique in that they didn't consent to any of the temporal things. As a matter of fact, in North America, they're the only ones set apart and set aside that took this whip as non-consenters. They're the only one that was in North America that was bought by chains. And chains enforced by guns and suffering and forced on ships and everything. And another thing that makes them very, very, very unique is that while they were attritioned out of their own wealth, even after a civil war was fought over them, and they was put in the Constitution as the true wealth holders by some very intelligent, genius men who looked towards a future paradise. Even after that, they was attritioned out of everything, and other people from around the world, everybody else was able to benefit from their 400 years investment. And this is the Abraham seed of Isaac that will bless many nations. Many nations benefited from their athleticism, from their ingenuity, from their soul music, you know, their soul music that has the frequency no other music has. It has the frequency. The only other music comes close is maybe reggae. But even reggae, King Bob Marley said that he was influenced a lot by Curtis Mayfield and American music. So you'll see a lot of influence of American music in reggae with a reggae beat to it. And I find this in, if you go to Hawaii, what they do now is in Hawaii is just remake over old soul music. A lot of the rappers and everybody is just looking and sampling soul music. See, because there's no place to go. It is really no place to go, because that is the eternal intelligence that Black people have already made and have and done. So everybody else is just a Johnny come lately. Even Blacks today, all they doing is sampling and picking up old stuff and adding it to raps and this like that. But what I want to say is that you better be careful, because you're messing with masterpieces. And this was masterpieces of music that was commissioned by King David. And just like artists have masterpieces, you know, these are masterpieces of cosmology and masterpieces of music that is singing of paradise and a future paradise. And it has the wave of a cosmic eternity in a lot of this music. So to mess with it, sample it, and try to replicate it for anybody else and trash it literally is blasphemous. It's blasphemous. Now, a lot of people want to own soul music. They're in full blasphemy, and they're going to be blasted. They're going to be blasted into the reality of living in their pastime paradise, thinking they're going to own the souls of black folk, which soul music came out of. These are those living in the pastime paradise. Anybody who thinks they're going to own soul music, soul train, anything black, is living in a pastime paradise. They living in a pastime paradise. They are in the abyss mentally. And just like the majority of whites in America, they wanted to pretend, oh, my white skin and my majority and me living in a pastime paradise means that I can just trample blacks and make sure all white senates and all white governors of any foreign bodies is sitting here in this country, and it won't affect me because I'm going to benefit from my pastime paradise, meaning my temporal immediate gratification. I don't care what it costs. I don't care what it costs me or my children. My pastime paradise of my immediate gratification of my Esau rights. My Esau rights to trample other birthrights after I done gave up mine. I got the right to take others after I done gave up and threw away my birthrights. My pastime paradise tell me I can infringe. I can take, I can pillage. I can not care about others. I can, walk over blacks, even though they constitution. I can sit in my little cubicles in the state and I can trample them and I can kick them around like tumbleweeds and I can deprive them out of everything, even though they have full body constitutional amendments and civil war was fought over them and they're in the supreme contract. So we have it in 2013, this white majority who lives in a pastime paradise is still talking about putting some white savior in, like a Ted Cruz or a Tea Party representative or, doing away with Obamacare or putting their lesbian and gay rights up and putting their Hispanic immigrant rights up, putting their Asian rights up. And so this pastime paradise includes a lot of people putting their Ethiopian, their African, rights up, all those at the UN is living in a pastime paradise. All the nations represented at the UN is living in a pastime paradise. So this is not just picking on whites, although they the majority in America who was the dung fuel for all evil, and they laid down a foundation by living in a pastime paradise, because according to them, the Civil War was never won. The Confederate and the Confederate flag is still all she wrote. White skin and oppressing blacks is the American way. See, that's their pastime paradise. And so their pastime paradise will now be given the full fruition. They will understand that they are the past. They are the abyss. They have a mental abyss of a pastime paradise. They did nothing for the everlasting kingdom and a future paradise. They wasn't willing to sacrifice nothing. Everything was like immediate gratification at the expense of everybody, and just the lack of compassion and inhumanity they showed towards these constitutional blacks says a lot. It says an awful lot about a lot of people in America. But it's almost really hard to even put your finger on to know that people can walk on two legs and be that inhumane towards a people who they know had already suffered 400 years, but their pastime paradise don't see suffering of nobody else. All their pastime paradise see is immediate gratification. That's a pastime paradise. You're in immediate gratification. You don't look to an eternal kingdom because you don't have the true soul faith of spirit to look to an eternal kingdom of a future paradise. So all you do is look for immediate gratification just as close as your nose. And that's all she wrote with you. And they're still living in it. They still think they're going to vote their way out of this in a white majority. They still think they're going to trample blacks forever. They still think that they're going to have, the black Tommy Sotomayors to buffer them, and the black, those who will sell out their women and nation. But see, the thing of it is, the pastime paradise has no resources, really. They only have illusion of resources. They only have illusions of grandeur. They only have illusions of a black puppet being enough to buffer them. They only have illusions of them giving anybody anything. They in a grand strong delusions, like Thessalonians said. They in a grand strong delusion of a, they never had anything. All they ever had was a pastime paradise, and that's all they lived on. They always lived in debt. They always lived in an abyss, but the was in a strong delusion of living in more, because they could not see past their nose. And like I said, their medical books didn't even identify a pineal gland. This is Mary Omni from the House of King David. Shalom.
When the Savior of love will come to stay, tell me who of them will come to be. How many of them are you? Graceflation, consolation, integration, verification of revelation, acclamation, world salvation, vibration, simulation, confirmation to peace of the world. Been spending most of their lives living in the past time paradise. Been spending most of their life living in a future paradise. They've been spending most of their life living in a future paradise. We've been spending too much of our life living in a past paradise. Let's start living on life, living for the future paradise. Hey, to our life, living for the future.
This is Mary Omni from the House of King David. Shalom.